friends, I'm Srishti and I'm back with another current affair for today. So today's topic is that US is witnessing an inverted yield curve. So is it a fuel for the fear of recession? So today we'll be going to discuss about this. So now we'll see that what all we are going to cover today. First is the current scenario, that is US facing an inverted yield curve. Second is the MCQ related to this, so that we can better understand the concept of this yield curve and the inverted yield curve. So through an MCQ, we'll try to solve and analyze the problem. The third one is, what is yield curve, different types of yield curve and how to interpret them. So how many types of yield curves are there and how we should interpret it, we will discuss it in detail. And the last one is the information conveyed by the yield curve, that why yield curve is so important and how does it convey the information related to the economic scenario. If you like my video, then do subscribe to our channel for regular updates. Now moving further and starting with the first topic, that is, why is the yield curve inverting in US? So we all know that US and China has been involved in the trade war, and these are the two largest economies, and they are creating uncertainty around the globe, around the world, and because of it, many trade tensions are also there. So now the investors are uncertain and they are rushing to buy US bonds as safe haven. Also, an inverted yield curve doesn't interpret good economic condition in the country. It is associated with the economic slumps and recession. So earlier also in US, when there was an inverted yield curve, the recession has followed immediately after that. Now what is the current scenario? That the yield on the 10-year note is 1.5708% and on 2-year note it is 1.5710%. So the spread has been narrowed, and this is why there is an inverted yield curve, because here it is the negative spread. Also, this yield curve which has been inverted in US, that is affecting other Asian economies also. So the Asian debt markets, they are also moving towards this fear of recession, because if we talk about Singapore, so the spread between Singapore's 2 and 10-year yields narrowed to 1 basis point, which is the lowest gap since November 2006. So we can say that the inverted yield curve in US, that has visible impacts on other economies also, and it is reaching the major Asian debt markets. Now as we all know that India is a part of Asia, so is India facing a similar situation as Singapore is facing? So the answer here is no. India's economy is facing other problems. Its financial sector is grappling with trillion of rupees in bad debt, and resolution of most cases is still low. Fear of probe agencies over fresh bad debts and a liquidity crunch are hampering lending by the banks. But if we talk about the interest rates, so the world is experiencing negative interest rates. For example, Germany has negative interest rates, but India continues to see high interest rate, and recently its 10-year bond yield rose for the 5th consecutive session and it closed at 6.6%. So we can see that India is unaffected by the inverted yield curve because its interest rates are still high as compared to the other developed economies. So this, we have talked about the current scenario about the US, which is facing the inverted yield curve, the Asian economy. One example was of Singapore, that its spread has been the lowest since November 2006. And then for our own country, we are talking about India. So we are comparing the scenario of the debt market in India versus other Asian economies. And in our case, we are talking and we are comparing it with Singapore. Now moving forward, the question is that yield curve is used to determine the current and future strength of the economy. US is witnessing inverted yield curve presently. Inverted yield curve indicates higher yields for short-term maturity bonds than the longer-term maturity bonds. How? So four options have been given to you, out of which you have to choose any one option. So before discussing each of the options, let's discuss the concept of yield curve and its types and the information which it conveys, so that it would be easier for you to answer the questions by yourself. Now, the basics of yield curve. What do you mean by yield curve? So, the YC curve, as we say it, it shows the relationship between the interest rate, or we can say yield, which is the cost of borrowing. Why is it called the cost of borrowing? Because yield is the required rate of return by the investors. So it becomes the cost of borrowing for the company which issues the bonds. So the yield curve shows the relationship between this yield and the time to maturity. What does time to maturity means? The short-term maturity may be for up to 1 year, and the long-term maturity bonds. So yield curve is here, it is the yield, and here it is the maturity. Now it could be either of the normal curve or the flat yield curve or the inverted yield curve, and we'll be discussing it later. We can also say that it is a way to measure the bond investors' feelings about the risk, which can have a tremendous impact on the returns. Because if an investor perceives risk, so the rate required by him would increase, and so does the yield will increase. So the risk perception, the premium which is added by the investors, play a key role here. Also, yield curve is generally indicative of future interest rates. Now, how can we say that? So, because future interest rates will be in accordance to the investing pattern of the investors now. So, if an investor perceives risk in future time, so he will increase his required rate of return and he will act accordingly, he will invest accordingly, so that his perception about the risk will come true and future interest rates would react accordingly. So this is what yield curve generally indicates. And yield curve is a very good measure, and they are really a good indicator of economy's expansion, that is growth, or contraction, that is recession. Now moving forward, the types of yield curve. So this is very important here to understand the concept and the types of yield curve and how do we interpret them. The first is the normal yield curve. So generally, normal yield curve is the one where it is upward sloping. What does it mean? So this is the maturity. These are the short term and these are the long term maturity bonds. So usually we see that an investor demands higher rate of interest for the long term maturity securities than for the short term. And why is it so? Because they have to give away their funds for a longer period. First, because it is uncertain, so therefore they demand higher returns. And secondly, there is a risk of inflation. So in order to compensate for these two risks which are faced by the investors, investors demand higher returns for the longer term maturity. And that is the reason that the yield is lower here and it rises for the long term maturity period securities. So now we have understood that how to look at this curve, how to interpret it. Let's discuss something interesting about it. So a normal curve indicates that yields on the longer term bonds may continue to rise, responding to periods of economic expansion. So when investors expect longer maturity bond yields to become even higher in the future, many would temporarily park their funds in shorter term securities in hopes of purchasing long term bonds later for higher yields. So it is all about the expectations of the investors. In a rising interest rate environment, it is risky to have investments tied up in longer term bonds when their value has yet to decline as a result of higher yields over time. So in order to simplify of what I said, we all know that bond price and yield are inversely related to each other. So if an investor expects that the interest rates, the yield will go up for the longer term maturity bonds as per the economic conditions of the country, so he would try to lock in his funds for the shorter term maturity bonds so that when they mature, they could be reinvested in the long term bonds at a higher interest rate. So this case is when the economic conditions are good. Under this case, the demand for short-term maturity bonds will rise in expectation of a higher interest rate in future for the long-term maturity. So the investors would try to invest in the short-term so that they could take the benefit and advantage of the higher interest rate for the longer term maturity bonds. So as a result, the demand for short term maturity bonds will rise, which will bring the bond prices increase, and as a result, the yields for the short term maturity bonds will decline. Similar happens in the case of the longer term maturities. Its demand goes down at present, which will reduce its bond price, and as a result, its yield goes up. And this is what is happening here, as you can see. So we have talked about the analysis that generally it reflects a stable and expanding economy. Relative steepness of the normal yield curve can provide clues about current and expected pace of the economic activity. So steeper the yield curve, faster will be the pace of economic growth expected by the investors. Now moving on to the flat yield curve. A yield curve goes flat when the spread for the longer term bonds drops to zero. What do you mean by spread? It means the difference in the yield between two bonds. So when the spread for long term bonds drops to zero, for example, the rate on 30-year bonds is no different than the rate on the 2-year notes. So when there is no difference between the interest rate or the yield demanded by the investors for different maturity of the bonds or the securities, the flat yield curve is there. And if this spread turns negative, the curve is considered inverted, which we will be discussing in the next section. So flat yield curve will appear in two conditions. First, when the economy is transitioning from expansion to slower development or even recession. The second scenario or the second condition when this could happen is when the economy is transitioning from recession to recovery and potential expansion. So talking about the first case, when the economy is transitioning from expansion to slower development and even recession, yields on the long maturity bonds, they tend to fall, and yields on the short-term securities likely rise, inverting a normal yield curve into a flat yield curve. So what I just said is, so we know that normal curve is like this. And if investors see that the economy is going towards recession, so what will they do? They will start to demand and they will start to lock in their funds for the longer term maturity in hopes that the interest rate will further fall. So they lock in their funds for the longer term maturity at the present rates, driving the yield for the long term maturity period to fall. So this will fall and the yields for the short term maturity will rise. Do not forget that bond price and yield are negatively correlated, and that is why as the demand for the long term maturity rises, its price goes up and thereby its yield will go down. So as per this, the short term maturity will come here and the long term maturity yield will go down, and we can get a flat yield curve over here. The next point, the next condition that we are going to discuss is from recession to recovery. So when the economy is transitioning from recession to recovery and potential expansion, yields on the longer maturity bonds are set to rise and yields on the short-term maturity securities are sure to fall, tilting an inverted yield curve towards a flat yield curve. So understanding it through an example, so this is how an inverted yield curve looks like. So we say that when an investor expects growth in an economy, he expects that the interest rate will rise in future. So why would he lock in his funds at the present interest rates for long-term maturity securities. He would rather invest in the short-term bonds so that at the time of their redemption, at their maturity period, they could be reinvested at a higher interest rate as expected for the longer-term maturity. So as the demand for the short-term maturity bonds rises, their yield will go down, and likewise, the yield of the long-term maturity bonds will go up. Similarly, we can get a yield curve over here, the flat yield curve. So I hope that you are able to understand these two concepts. So what is the analysis here? That a flat yield curve may arise from normal or inverted curve, as we have discussed above in the diagrams, depending on changing economic conditions. So two economic conditions have been discussed. First was from expansion to recession, and the next one was from recession to recovery and potential expansion. Now we are going to discuss the inverted yield curve, and this is really important because the news says that US is facing an inverted yield curve. So does US is going into recession or not? So when does the inverted yield curve is there? When there is negative spread for the bonds, or we can say when the short-term yields offered are higher than the longer term yields, as we can see that the short term yields are higher as compared to the yields offered on the long term maturity. So when does this happen? When investors expect, so the answer to this question is when investors expect longer maturity bond yields to become even lower in the future. So many would purchase the longer maturity bonds now to lock in yields before they decrease further. So say if you are an investor and you see that the economy is not doing good, so what will you do? The interest rates now suppose is on long term maturity 10%, and you see that as the economy is not doing good, the interest rate on the long term maturity, which is now 10%, will further fall to suppose 5%. So you would definitely invest now in the longer term bonds at 10%, and suppose the bond is of 10 years, so this means that for 10 years you will lock in your funds at 10%. And what will be the case if you lock in your funds for in the short term maturity bonds? So as you know that when the economy is not doing good, the government also comes in and it reduces the interest rate to boost up the economy. So when the interest rates will go down, the short term maturity bonds or the securities will not perform good. So this is the best choice over here, that you will lock in your funds in the longer term maturity bonds to lock in the yields at 10% before they decrease further to 5%. I hope that I have made myself clear. So if you talk this in the same terms as we have talked the normal yield curve and the flat yield curve, in terms of the bond price, the demand over here, and thereby the yield. So if we talk about this, it says that the increasing onset of demand for longer maturity bonds, that is demand goes up for the longer maturity bonds, and the lack of demand for the shorter term securities leads to higher prices for the long term bonds, but yield will go down, and vice versa will happen for the shorter term maturity bonds, that the prices here will go down and the yields will rise. And this is what we can see in the diagram over here. Now a very interesting question which follows is that why would the long term investors settle for lower rewards than the short term investors who are assuming less risk? So the answer is, when long term investors believe that this is their last chance to lock in current rates, notice the word here, current rates, before they fall even lower, they become slightly less demanding of the lenders because they have a fear that the short term yields may be lowered to stimulate the economic activity. So again, understanding it, we know, as we have discussed, that there are two participants, investors, and the others are borrowers. So investors demand securities. So here, in the short-term maturity bonds and for the long-term maturity bonds, when the investors perceive recession or they perceive that the economy is not doing good, so what they do is, so the demand here will go down, and as investors will demand more of longer term maturity bonds to lock in their funds at the current rates before they actually go down further, so the demand here will go up. As a result, the price here will go down and the price will increase for the longer term maturity bonds, which makes the yield as here it will increase and here it is going down, which is the inverted yield curve which we have discussed right now. Now the question is that why does it actually matter? Because yield curve is used to determine the actual scenario, actual strength of the economy. And historically also, 11 years back in US, when there was an inverted yield curve, the recession has followed thereby. Yield curve also predict the investing pattern of the investors. By looking at the yield curve, an investor could perceive the ongoing scenario of the economy and he could actually invest, making good for himself. So coming back to the current scenario, and I think that you will be able to better understand this now. So the current scenario was that US is facing inverted yield curve, and I have mentioned the yield on the 10-year note versus on the 2-year note. So here we can see that there is a negative spread over here. So this means that the bondholders are worried about economic weakness and not inflation, which usually picks up in a growing economy. Developed economies have had low inflation for decades, because when an investor sees inflation in the future time, he increases his required rate of return, or the yield as we say. Now the question was that the inverted yield curve indicates higher yield for the shorter term maturity bonds and the longer term maturity bonds. So the question is that the inverted yield curve indicates higher yields for short term maturity bonds than the long term maturity bonds. So to recall how inverted yield curve looked like, it is like this. This is the short term and this is the long term. The supplier of loanable funds, this is the investor, because the investor supplies the funds in the economy by demanding the securities, in our case the bonds. And the borrower of loanable funds is the company, and the borrower represents the demand side for the loanable funds. So the first option is that the supplier of loanable funds demands short-term maturity bonds and borrower of loanable funds wishes to get funds for the long term. Second option is supplier of loanable funds demands long-term maturity bonds and the borrower of loanable funds wishes to get funds for the short term. Third option is supplier of loanable funds demands short-term maturity bonds and borrower of loanable funds also wishes to get funds for the short term. And the last option says that both the supplier and the borrower of the loanable funds, they demand and they wishes to get the long term maturity bonds. So recalling what we have understood, that in the inverted yield curve, the investor tries to lock in funds in the longer term maturity bonds at the current rate in fear that the interest rate will go down further. So for the supplier of the loanable funds, that is the investors, they demand the longer term maturity bonds. And if we talk about the borrower or the company which issues the bonds, now with the same perception in our heads that the economy is not doing good, the borrower wants to minimize his cost of borrowing, and as he can see that the yield curve shows lower yields for the longer term maturity bonds in future, and he would be therefore willing to get the funds for the short term so that he doesn't have to lock in the funds, he doesn't have to give the interest rates to the investor at a higher rate now, because the interest rates could fall further in future time. So it will be beneficial for the borrower to take the funds for the short-term maturity bonds, as the interest rate is likely to go down in future, and then he could take the advantage of the reduced interest rate. So the answer to our question is option number B, where the supplier of the loanable funds demands for the long-term maturity bonds and borrower of loanable funds wishes to get funds for the short term. I hope that you have understood this concept. This is a really important topic and the concept that follows. If you like my video, then do subscribe to our channel for regular updates. Thank you.